Dear student, today I am going to discuss question number 9 from the kinematics. In this question, this is based on the graph. Very simple graph is there, but one little bit technique is behind this graph. That's why I am solving over here. First of all, in the graph, xt graph is given by this way. And you need to calculate in first what average velocity during 0 to 10 seconds. First of all, in part A, average velocity. Let this is the average velocity from 0 to 10 seconds. What is the average velocity basically? That is total displacement upon time. Total displacement is x and time is t. Change in displacement, final displacement, that is at 10 seconds. You can see here at 10 seconds, 10 second final displacement is 100. So you can write here 100. Initial displacement you take at 0 second, that is 0. Minus 0 you can take here. This change in displacement upon change in time. Upon time, that is 10 minus 0. And finally, average velocity is 100 upon 10. 10 will cancel out, that will be 10 meters per second. Similarly, in part B, you need to calculate the instantaneous velocity at 2, 5, 8 and 12 seconds. First of all, 2 seconds. At 2 seconds, you need to generalize one more concept here. If you are calculating the slope in a curve along a straight line, let this is angle theta, it means this is corresponding angle theta. This is also corresponding angle theta. It means at a straight line, every point slope will be same. Straight line slope is same at every point. At every point, you need to remember this particular concept over here. It means whatever velocity we are getting at 2.5 seconds, same velocity we will get 2 seconds. 0 to 2.5 seconds, you have a straight line. That's why you have a same angle everywhere. And you see. So that's why velocity at 2 seconds, I can write velocity at 2 seconds is equal to slope means perpendicular. Perpendicular is 50 upon time is 2.5. And slope is positive because this is a positive slope. That's why it will be 500 divided by 25. Now solve it, that is 20. Finally, answer will be 20 meter per second. This is the instantaneous velocity at 2 seconds. Similarly, at 5 seconds, instantaneous velocity at 5 seconds. Just see in the diagram, this is a 5 second. At 5 seconds, you can see here, slope is 0. If slope is 0, it means velocity is 0 meters per second. Similarly, velocity at 8 seconds. You can see 8 seconds over here. This is the 8 seconds here. Might be over here 8 seconds. But you see, from 10 to 15 seconds, you will get the same slope along the straight line. That's why whatever slope you are getting at 15 seconds, same slope you will get at the 10, above 10, 10.5 to 12.5, 11, 8, all. But here, we need to calculate the velocity at 8 seconds. At 8 seconds, you are here. Not here. At 8 seconds, you are here. Here, in order to calculate the slope, you need to draw the right angle triangle in order to calculate the 10 theta also. This particular slope, you will get, this is a perpendicular, that is 100 minus 50. 100 minus 50. And this base you can see here, that is 10 minus 7.5. So you can write 100 minus 50 divided by 10 minus 7.5. That will be 50 upon, again, 10 minus 7.5, that is 2.5. It means 25, 0 here. And finally, that will be 20 meter per second again. Now, velocity at 12 second. 12 second means it lie between 12.5 and 15, same slope you are getting. Whatever slope you are getting at 15, same slope you will get here. That's why that will be here, right angle triangle is this, which is perpendicular is 100, negative slope is there, and divided by 15 minus 10, that is 5, and finally that is minus 20 meters per second. What is the concept behind this mechanism? This is the concept. Along a straight line, slope is same at every point. Thank you very much.